You were beginning to mention that Demape has been helpful, not so much in the scoring, but in the assist department. Game one, 3 assists. Game two, 3. Game three, he in fact issued 5 assists. So it's just his confidence level that remains to be uplifted in the course of the game. Here we go. Game number 4 underway. We are looking for an opponent for Negros. And the first shot of Compton, there's a foul, and it will be on Omanzi Rodriguez, and it will send Compton to the line. Danny, there's no question. I think as Alex Compton goes, so goes Manila. When Compton is in high gear when he's scoring, Manila usually wins.
You know, and let's say Alex Compton, he never leaves his teammates out, if you notice. Even if masama yung laro niya, he still eggs on his teammates. Kung may mga pagkakamali siya, he would apologize to his teammates. And that is the mark of a true leader. Now, my concern right now, as Alex Compton hits his first free throw, is that whenever you start a ball game, I mean, you start off fast and strong, malaking bagay na kagad dyan. Yan yung instant grabbing of the momentum. So
yes, exactly. Seizing the initiative right away, and Manila applying the pressure quickly. Compton, 25 points, 4 rebounds, 6 assists in game number 3, averaging 19 as you saw on the graphic earlier. We'd like to check on our Bravo Realm matchup right now and check on the players who will be expected to shine for their respective teams. Calagio continues to be a hot hand.
Of course, itong 26% ang kanyang 3-point field goal, kailangan pa niya i-up yan. At itong si Rafi Rivas naman, talagang kakailanganin niya yung suporta ni Chris Calagio, because if Chris Calagio cannot hit from the outside, Rafi Rivas is a player who cannot really post up that well nung nanggagaling na sa labas itong manlalaro ito.
Talagang with his back to the basket, nahihirapan siya. Victulero is a significant starter here today. He did not start yesterday. Compton releases a 3. It'll go. Alex is all business here in the early goings.
He's got a total of 5 points. And that's the whole production of the Manila Metro Stars at the start of the game.
In the meantime, Chris Calagi with a strong drive to the hoop collected the foul from Demape. First on Demape, and that will count as the first on the Manila Metro Stars as a unit. Here's Victulero looking inside. Here's Dasha, the snap from the right flank, no connection. Dasha was significantly limited in game number 3, netting only 7 points. In the meantime, it's the first report coming from Ria Tanwalco with this Advil courtside update. Ria?
Okay, well, Steve, itong si Coach Boyce Summer ay nakakatawa talaga. Sabi niya sa kanyang mga players kanina na, guys, let's simplify the game. Simplify the game nga. Pero ang dami niyang utos na bigay. Now, he just wants his boys to focus on the simple things. They don't want to think about playing on Wednesday. They want to think about tying the series. So on defense, they want to make Sun 1 bleed for their points. Chris Calagio, they want to double team him right away and limit them to 15 points per quarter. On offense, they want to be able to score more than 20 per quarter, and they want to defend their home court successfully one last time this season. Seb?
Thank you very much for that Advil courtside update. Advil, advanced medicine for pain. That seems to be a reasonable target, that 15 points with the way San Juan has played in the third quarter. On the other hand, 20 is that manageable, and let's score 20, at least more than the other team.
Well, I would say that's manageable, and sinabi nga, when you simplify the game, you expect your players to understand what you want to point out, and it looks like ito si Coach Boyce Samar has gotten to his team to understand that they have to score more points, but they have to play defense as well.
Just can't be a game of outscoring the other. Calagio's attempt from afar will not work here. It's Brown. Compton tries to manage the basketball. He's hounded by Victulero. It will stay with the Metro Stars. While we're screaming here, we'll try to get to JC Gonzalez for his first Advil courtside update.
Okay, thanks, guys. This game might very well boil down to who can outrun the other. Coach Philip Cesar pointed out very significant stat in the game yesterday is that Manila outran San Juan, and he said, guys, this is our game, not their game. Don't let them beat us at our own game. And significant enough, these first few points you've seen Manila convert on a lot of fast break points. Secondly, more adjustments from yesterday's game. He wants double time on the players off the bench from Manila. What happened was too much emphasis was given on Romelo Ducol, Peter Martin, and Alex Compton, but the names like Ang, Longa Longco, and Serrano all stepped up big yesterday. So he just reminded this to his Knights. Guys, back to you.
Thanks a lot, JC. And that was an Advil courtside update. Just to amplify what JC was talking about, fast break points, that was the edge of San Juan in the first two games. 22-2 in game one, 15-10 in the second game, but in the third game, a complete reversal, 30-21 in favor of the Metro Stars.
And it looks like Manila is off to a fast start.
Yun ang gusto nilang gawin, Danny Francisco. They love it when they're in the open court. Compton drills that in.
And if you notice, they want to shock their opponents. So itong San Juan, you cannot count them out. They're just down by 5 points at the moment. But with the aggressiveness being shown by the Manila Metro Stars, San Juan may want to counter it by going to their half-court set. They've got the height advantage here in their starting unit.
Chris Calagio gets a look inside. Just a few centimeters was all he needed. Calagio in the third game, lowest output of 15. Hottest was game one, wherein he netted 20. Demape lobs it over to Brown. Brown fires. It will trickle in. ...11-6 count, 8:27 remaining. Oh, it's Dasha dropping to the deck, and Manila is off and running with a 5-point lead. Will they increase on it? They will miss that particular shot. That will count. Kung amateur basketball yan, FIBA rules, pwede mong galawin
yan. Pwede mong galawin yan, pero here in the professional league, you cannot touch the ball when it's above the rim.
8 minutes and 12 seconds remaining. Victoletto tries to organize the offensive line. Calagio takes a peek inside, sends it to Chito. The guard line will have to produce for San Juan here today.
And I feel that itong X-factor para sa San Juan Knights, itong si Chito Victoletto, because he can pop that 15-footer. Ang ganda ng pagka-screen para kay Chito Victoletto. Now, intelligence will come into play. How smart will you play this game, especially kung veterano ka na, sir? Because you've got to get everybody involved. Hindi lang yun. Yung mga pasa mo should be precise.
Exactly. In the same way that Johnny Del Cardel, as Miko and Butch were pointing out earlier, held that team together with his leadership. And you mentioned that also while we were watching the earlier game, which was won, by the way, by Negros 93-68. That's a 23-second violation. And we take a look at the surprise packages that came in nice wrappers in game number three.
You know, it eases off the pressure of Romelo Ducal when you have Peter Martin scoring 17 points, grabbing 7 rebounds, and having 2 steals. Frecce Ang, that is a surprise package for Coach Boyce Samar. Look at the rebounding story for Frecce Ang, 7 rebounds.
Victoletto's attempt will not connect to the rebound controlled by Brown. One of the big factors that has been neutralized by Manila is the rebounding edge that everybody thought San Juan would have going into the course of the series. So it's really been a series that has been brought down to who can score the more baskets under the pressure that we have right now. And the foul is on Rivas, his first. 7 minutes and 3 seconds remaining. But you know, take nothing away from Cebu. What a nice run by Cebu this year. Tunichi Ituri doing a marvelous job of getting that team back into the Southern Conference Finals. Just happens to be when he gets to Bacolod, that seems to be, there's some venues that don't go to your liking, that don't go your way. Compton lobs it inside to Adugo, rejected by Omanzi Rodriguez. Downstairs we got Manila, extremely aggressive, but so is San Juan. Lead pass, Dasha, oh, well done play.
Well, Dasha just using his leaping ability to just fly by Ibet Demape. That was a good move in terms of not bringing the ball down. Alam niya na kaya niyang talunan itong si Ibet Demape.
Yes, and with the way Demape's confidence has been shot so far, it's there for the picking. Demape will take this shot. No, I speak too soon. He decides to inch in closer. Maybe that will boost his confidence. Even Philip Cesar noticed that in his interview. Sinabi niya, medyo hindi pa maganda ang laro ni Demape. In the meantime, Demape lost control. Calagio trying to establish control. Calagio behind the back pass to Umanzi, outside to Rivas. He won't shoot from there. That'll go to Dasha. The baseline flip. It connects.
At umiinit na rin ito si Bruce Dasha already with 4 points. It's quite important also for Bruce Dasha to start off the game for San Juan, because pagka namawis na to, he gets into the groove of things, komportable na kagad siya, pati sa kanyang outside shot.
Exactly. Throughout the series, San Juan has taken the first quarter. That seems to be their strong suit. The third seems to be their Achilles heel. In the meantime, a foul. Rodriguez with his second foul. Ang major concern in Philip Cesar is that his main shot blocker has been called for two fouls. And the Metro Stars use a timeout. We'll be back.
Why is JC Gonzalez laughing at the sidelines? I wonder why, but JC...
I think he's just trying to compliment Miko and Butch,
okay,
who were
okay.
Obviously enjoying themselves earlier. Look at that smile. Huh? Look at that. Look at that. A face that launched 1,000 telephones. Okay, 5:36 to go. Four-point lead, Metro Stars with the early lead. Ano yung kulo na yan? Uminit, ano?
Uminit.
Surge. Ano ito? Bababa na konti.
Well, it's beginning to simmer down, but for the Manila Metro Stars, they just want to keep it at that level, yung kanilang umpisa. But now, you bet the map, you bring the ball down, taking out Alex Compton from the equation. Magkakaroon ng two-man game. Itong si Ibet Demape at saka si Romel Dukul.
Demape starting strongly here. Best start by Demape in the series so far. You know, yesterday, Boise Summer was yelling at his stars, at Dukul and Compton. They were not playing the two-man game. You think that's the bread and butter really of Manila?
Well, for one, itong si Alex Compton just knows how to use the screens being given by Romel Dukul. But the thing is, with Ibet Demape there, and Peter Martin, actually, you've got two strong sides. Pero kailanganin yun, because right now, what Manila is doing is that they're overplaying whatever pick is being set up for him.
Exactly. And we have the time down to 2:53, 6-point Manila lead. We'll take a short break and return very quickly to San Andres.
Tapos na si Sam at luluwag nga ng konti ang schedule natin. Si Ira Panganiba, naghahanap ng masisigawan ng mag-golf yun eh. Kung mag-golf yun, parang basketball eh.
Tapobres. Nothing. Newton, aggressive rebound. Almost had it. But we'll be getting a foul here. Chucho Serrano, let's wait. Let's It's on Joel Gohis first. You know, Danny, one of the problems of San Juan in the course of the series has been their very poor free throw shooting. Only 46%. A total of 37 out of 79 attempts in the course of this series so far.
And to think that they played the first two games in San Juan, they've got to make do with their free throws. Very important factor in the ball game. Newton misses his first.
Game one, San Juan had 9 of 19. Game two, 7 of 22. Game three, 21 of 38. So it's something where they could get a lot of points, but it has not happened for them. It's something that they don't work on. You know, that's the only place on the court where you can be greedy and still be helpful to your team. Serrano zigzagging like a train. And by the way, lest I forget to introduce our officials, Haminal, Pabes, and Garcia have the whistles this afternoon. This is referee Haminal making the call against Calagio. First on Calagio. On the other hand, Manila has been hitting 60.8%. Ano ba ang magandang percentage, Danny? Mga 70, 80%?
Oo, acceptable yan, mga 75 to 80.
Manila hit 73% in game 3, 16 of 22 from the stripe just yesterday. They struggled in game 1, hitting only 19 of 36. So, tama yung stat natin kanina, no? Some reversals of numbers. I think really the effect of changing courts has some kind of effect on both these teams. Chucho Serrano can't nail the second. It's a 21-14 first quarter with 2:25 remaining.
You know, San Juan is using a much taller lineup. Ito si Newton going up against Chucho Serrano. Some mismatches. Calagio is just being picked up by Joel Co. But they've got to be careful about that ball.
And Philip Cesar has the stare on his team. Guys, what are we doing? You know, pag nagta-turnover yung team, ano yung stare ni Philip Cesar, ano? Balingit picks up the loose change. And Randy Alcantara with our first presentation of our No Fear Slam Dunk. San Juan down by 5 here. They were down by as large as 7 when it was 13-6. Aduko driving hard. You know, Aduko has had to develop that seemingly awkward shot ever since he was injured. But this is a straight and true connection.
And he needs that time of a shot, especially if Balingit is guarding him. Nasabihin ko na sana, Sev, na itong Manila Metro Stars, eh, kailangan bilisan nila yung laro because eh, pagka mag-half court set sila, dehado sila, mas malalaki itong San Juan.
Yes. Alcantara spots from three-point distance. It will not sink in. Could be a foul against Balingit.
But they call it against Romel Aduko.
Yeah, because I was just looking at Romel's reaction. He's trying to pull a fast one. Here's the shot. Look at the corner, left corner. ...23-16, a minute and 15 remaining. Juan Ted Donaldson will present himself to the floor, and Romel Aduko will hit the bench for the first time. The big man, Aduko, already with 4 points. His best game in terms of points was the second, wherein he scored 22. Balingit nets the first, earns the second. Aduko, in terms of rebounds, always in double figures in the first three games. 13 in game one, also the same number in game two. Had 16 in game three. Balingit muffs the second one. And where is this going? To Manila. A minute and 11 seconds remaining. Here Serrano tries to get it across. May have been a backing violation. Hard to call from that point. But Calagi says, okay, you worry about that call.
You know, with that steal by San Juan, cutting the lead down to just 4 points, the guards of Manila will have to give up the ball. And a foul given up by Randy Alcantara.
As you check out this FedEx fast break, let's pursue that point you were mentioning. The guards will have to give up the ball earlier, Danny?
Oo, kailangan. Kasi unang-una, malalaking kumukuha sa kanila. Therefore, the coverage, yung kanilang line of sight, eh, talagang kahit paano, eh, lumiliit, no?
Yes.
Kasi siyempre, mas malaki yung kumukuha sa'yo. Problem is, you want to bring it down the middle because you've got two sides of the court. If you bring it to one side and you get clamped down there, chances are you're going to pirouette your way. Once you do the spin move, itong sila Calagio, mahilig tumapit ng bola sa likod. Eh.
Yes. Just to amplify that, imagine me or Miko Halili trying to dribble against our analyst here today. Those two were joyful earlier, didn't you notice?
Very much. Probably naka horseback riding ito si Miko Halili.
In the meantime, we're down to 43 seconds. Serrano unable to get to it because Newton stood in his path. Dasha tries to control it. Undergoes tap cup progress. San Juan roaring back here, down by just 4. Joel Koh. Here's Brown trying to backpedal. Shot clock reduced to 9. Serrano tries to sidestep. It'll count if it goes, yes. After Alcantara's first foul has collected a sum of 17 fouls. Serrano will be on the stripe. Takes care of the bonus. Seven-point lead for the home squad. Alcantara, moment of indecision, back to Newton. They're trying to get it downstairs to Bonnell. They managed to do that. Donaldson has to apply everything. And this first quarter draws to a close. Manila seizing the initiative, leading early here, repeating their biggest lead of 7. We'll have more of our northern half of the conference finals just after this.
they sustained the momentum given up by Alex Compton in the opening minutes. Ang San Juan naman, they've been getting their shots, the shots that they'd like to take. However, they cannot seem to control yung second stringers ng Manila. Parang, you know, you've got to respect the second stringers of Manila because they are the defending champions and
exactly.
They get the job done.
I think that was so correctly pointed out by Philip Cesar at the top of this telecast when he said, pare, suspense ako yung bench, gagawa yan. And exactly, the bench produced for Manila in Game 3. In the meantime, Alcantara to Bonel, who is aching for a basket, gets one. Light is on JC Gonzalez. Can we go to JC for the Advil courtside update? Go ahead, please.
Okay, thank you very much, guys. The Knights of Philip Cesar getting a tongue lashing in the top of at the top of the second quarter, saying that second five na nga ng Manila yung nakapasok sa first quarter nila, nakababad sila. Still, we did not get the job done. First of all, he goes to remind them, guys, turnovers natin just way too much. Manila had 20 points off turnovers in game number 3, and he doesn't want this to happen again. And finally, just an update on Bruce Dasha. He says his finger is still hurting, pero hindi niya pinapansin yung sakit. Tuloy pa rin siya maglaro. Guys, back to you.
Thanks a lot, JC, for the Advil courtside update. Fisca Pobres, Dino Manuel, who didn't see action yesterday, trying to stay with Capobres, but Capobres just too hot to handle. He has his second field goal. Rhea will join us from the other side of the floor, from the side of the Metro Stars.
Okay, well, at this point, Coach Boyce Isama really feels that his boys' offense is a little shaky. He's not happy with it, and he can't emphasize enough that for his boys in Manila, their first option is to run and to attack. The problem is a lot of the big men are lagging behind, and they must step up and run so they can meet the ball. And just to show you how important fast breaks are for Manila, they scored 30 points off fast breaks yesterday out of 24 tries. So really, that's something they want to replicate here today. And important also is the fact that they need to get their confidence here in this quarter, right?
Thanks a lot, Rhea, for that Advil courtside update. Advil for advanced medicine for pain. Now, Danny, let's go and amplify what Rhea just said. Yung running together, that's developed if you are accustomed to playing together.
Yes. But it seems like itong Manila Metro Stars, as Jolto hits, it's a fact that they wanted to go to their fast break game. However, the pitches that they threw in the first quarter, about 2 to 3 passes were picked off by the San Juan Knights. So kahit paano, the intention has been there. It's just that San Juan has been quite intelligent to go back down on defense.
And defensively also, we saw some opportunities wherein Martin was dribbling the ball. Peter Martin was dribbling the ball, and he was at the point of the fast break but could not move as well. We have a foul against Balingit, his first, and that will count as the first team foul of the Knights in the second quarter.
And you know, Sev, itong Manila Metro Stars, no? Dito sa umpisa ng second quarter, nakadikit na itong San Juan Knights. If you notice, with the second unit, they do not run their two-man game. They're not comfortable with the two-man game. They always have to have a Romelo Ducal underneath.
Yes. And in the meantime, Chuchu Serrano, taking it against the entire San Juan team, ends up collecting a foul. Bruce Dasha will get his first. Now, Manila has also found a source of points from the free throw line. Opening quarter, 7 of 9 from the stripe. While on the other hand, San Juan continues to struggle from that sector, only 1 of 4 for a very paltry 25% from the free throw stripe. So please, please, those of you studying this game, learn to shoot your free throws. Even you, Mr. Serrano.
But you know, for somebody who's going to be defending Chuchu Serrano in this game, I would say you just have to give Serrano the outside shot.
You know, challenge him. Challenge him.
If you notice, kasi his quickness will get the better of him, especially when he drives through the basket. At kahit paano, because of his height, once mag-initiate lang ng contact dun sa help defense ng San Juan, I'm sure that pipituhan niya.
Yes. Chuchu Serrano, of course, long-time asset of the UP Fighting Maroons. There's Longalong, tried to go one-handed, but there was a pickpocket job by Vic Toledo. Nice Simeco steal there. Penetration, that'll count!
And a big three-point play opportunity being presented to Randy Alcantara.
Romelo Ducal ends up collecting his second personal foul in that sequence. Earlier, Now, this is not the Semeco steal. This is not the Semeco steal. This one earlier, it was actually done by Vic Valero. I'm sure Semeco would like to see an actual steal. Okay. 31-27. Alcantara tries to complete the three-point play. It's a rim rattler. Then Mappe tries to step through that particular defensive web. The Mappe's muscle got stepped through, not using his pivot foot well. Shot clock reduced to four. Manila was begging for a whistle, any kind.
That's going to be number two against Bonel Balingit. Watch this. They will always try to go to that two-man game, the bump by Bonel Balingit.
Ano ba yan? Recover long, recover short. Mark Molina was beginning to teach us about that yesterday. In the meantime, some first quarter numbers.
Well, the free throws is what you've mentioned, hurting the San Juan Knights 25%, but they only attempted four times as compared to the 78%, that's 7 out of 9 for the Manila Metro Stars. Fast break points, ang San Juan pa ang namuno. 10 against 6, and the field goes Manila, hitting a high 59, 10 out of 17.
As Compton drills in that one, but that edge of San Juan just supports and confirms what Rhea was talking about earlier, that Boise Samar wants his team to run, because as Rhea also mentioned, game three, that was a clear edge for Manila. 6-point lead. Randy Alcantara bounces off the rim. That shot, Adukol clears. Compton will not force the issue. Will wait for the rest of the brigade. Cross court to Brown. The starting unit is on the floor for Manila. The curl for the basket, Tanwatko has it. Oh, I'm sorry. Tanwatko is our reporter.
But you know, Sev, going back to what Leah said about the fast break opportunities for Manila, fast break points for Manila in the first quarter, 6 against 10 by San Juan. You know why? Because San Juan out-rebounded the Manila Metro Stars 14 against 10. 8 coming off the defensive boards and 5 coming off the offensive glass,
yes,
for the San Juan Knights.
Adukol hit a jumper early, hits one again. Could be one of those big game days for the big man.
And that's the liability of having a Bonel Balingit there, because Romel can pop from the outside. What if Balingit suddenly presses against Romel Adukol? Iba na yan.
Jemapi fakes the pass. Oh, what a great play! Initiated by the ball, steal by Compton. He wants a three. It will be a three if it goes. He was going for the dramatic there. Peter Martin calls for it. Compton says, let me try again. But wait, wait, wait. We're getting ahead of the story. Brown says, let me. No, he decides to take it. It will not go in. Wala sa tiempo lahat yung tira nila. Rivas, where is this going? Alcantara has to hustle for it. Dasha twirling around. Compton is a pesky customer. And they decide to settle down. Inside to Bonel. A hot tender embraced by Peter Martin.
And that is, you've got to give credit to Coach Boyce Saman. Nagpalit lang siya ng tao ng bahagya. They responded right away.
Rivas, ball handling of San Juan has been lethargic here in the second quarter. Philip Cesar can only shake his head. The Victulera trying to keep their hopes alive with several steals. Philip Cesar, there he is. Deep corner there. Here's Rivas. Rivas attacking. You know, so much has been said about the ability of Manila to score, to run, to hustle as Demape misses a shot. But please take note of their defense, the way they are forcing San Juan to shoot not their normal shots.
Yan ang nangyayari sa kanila ngayon. They think that from the wing side, kaya nila atakihin yung basket. Yung problema, pagkalipad nila, wala na yung bola sa kanila kasi ang bibilis ng mga kamay nitong Manila Metro Stars.
And then we're beginning to talk about the assists in game number three. Manila with a clear edge, as we highlighted that particular category in terms of the stats. Manila with the edge 24-10 in game three. 7 minutes and 9 seconds in the balance here. But no matter what happens to this series, Bruce Dasha has made a name for himself. Yes. He has been most impressive. started unti-unti, lalo na ng series against Laguna yata. Rasha's trying to use his wingspan against Demape. Demape with a quick curl, forces his way through. He's looking for a foul more than anything else. Demape pays for that one. He was looking for a foul more than anything else. Knights will use a ceasefire. They're down by 8, 37-29, 6:52 remaining. Your NBA will be back. Yesterday I was completely I was totally unprepared to talk about Ferreyros. It looks like Ferreyros is out of for the season.
Yes, I believe 8 weeks. No? And this has given the opportunities to the bench players to really shine for the Negro Slashers.
I think like Leo Batog really performed so well in that series against Cebu. In the meantime, Victulero decides to take a crack at it. So much will be needed from the guards of San Juan to take this series and to be able to proceed into that national showdown against Negros.
You know what the big guys of San Juan must understand is that they've got a point guard in Chito Victulero who can spot up.
Correct.
This is a 15-foot line. At kailangan nilang pagbihan si Chito ng mga tira dahil naman kinaklag talaga yung shaded area ng Manila.
Compton, Victulero has hands everywhere. Martin, it's jammed, but Alcantara giving up the foul. Second game was a good rebounding game for Peter Martin, a total of 13 rebounds in that game. And now shooting 2 of 3 from the free throw line. That will not work. JC Gonzalez has this Advil courtside update.
Thanks, guys. Coach Philip Cesar pointed out earlier in that last timeout, the reason of why Manila's lead is this big, it shouldn't have been, but the thing is wasted fast break points on the part of San Juan. They're not executing their fast breaks properly. A lot of one-on-one plays are happening. They're not even looking for the cutter or the open man to pass to. He goes, I'll only give you the license to go 1-1 if you're playing exceptionally well. Pero as of late, mukhang wala pang ganun. Guys, back to you.
So many virtuosos without a maestro, without any... orchestra conductor. So thank you for that Advil courtside update. Advil for advanced medicine for pain. On the other side of the floor, Ria Tanuatu will join us and tell us the latest about the Metro Stars in this Advil courtside update.
Sure will. Well, in that last timeout, the Boise Summer have to remind the players they have got to keep their focus and they have to play above the officiating. Siya na lang daw ang maglambing-lambingan sa ating mga referees dito. And in terms of X's and O's, he had none. He said, guys, I have nothing to tell you but to play because he trusts his players and the philosophy he employed yesterday in the game was to give his players the freedom to do what they want to do. Guys?
Thanks a lot, Ria, for that Advil courtside update. As Ria was speaking, there's a bad sign happening for San Juan. It's Demape suddenly exploding here. Demape already with 6 points, which matches his output in the first game. On the other side of the floor, while JC was speaking, it was Chito Victulero's turn to pop in a basket. He has now collected 8 points. Alcantara misses the free throw. He's watching. Rondon Hontiveros. He was here also when Cebu went for the title against Manila in the Intracon. In the meantime, it's 40-34. Victulero, pick and roll, Rivas scores. You know, I've always used this description. There are some players who just, when they drive to the basket, parang magkakahiwalay-hiwalay yung katawan nila. And Rivas joins that club. Look at this. As this pick and roll is done well, he doesn't go straight up. He will bob. He's like a flyweight, actually. But he will score on that bravo run play.
Timing is very important in that two-man game. Run by Victulero and Rafa Rivas. Exacto, exacto lang. Pagkabitaw ni Rivas, binigyan na kagad siya ng bola.
Rivas knocks in the bonus. He has 3 points. And the lead of Manila is trimmed down to 3. There's Brown across the midcourt line. Keep in mind that San Juan leads the series 2-1. There's Demape. Trying to curl, gets it, he has 8 in the game.
And they're running some isolation plays for Ibid Demape, challenging the defense of a Chris Calagio.
Best output so far by Dimape as far as scoring is concerned. Here's Capobres. Victulero is open. They don't see him yet, but Capobres says, let me take care of that. Capobres with a six-point collection. 42-39 ang ating bilang. Lamang ng tatlo ang tagamayan nila. 4 minutes and 5 seconds po ang nalalabi dito sa second quarter. Peter Martin looks for some help and Capobres sends it outside.
Alam mo, yung natural tendency talaga pagka malaki kang tao, nagbababa ka ng bola. No? Hindi mo ibababa dun sa area na hindi ka komportable. Ang chances are, kung point guard ka, pipihitin mo, dadalhin mo sa gitna. Pero kung malaking tao ka, hahawakan mo yung bola eh. Kasi unang-una, hindi ka dapat magbaba ng bola. Pangalawa, hindi mo posisyon na magdala ng bola.
Okay, but you, being a center, did you have to learn how to... I knew you could dribble the ball as early as high school. But did you have to add a spin move sa'yo?
Kailangan eh. Pero yung chances are, pagka malaki ka talaga, when you go for that spin move, may manggagaling from the blind side na gwardiya eh. Because you must remember, yung dumidepensa ang gwardiya, ang lugar niya na just above the keyhole area.
Yes.
So pagka pumihit ka, going to the middle, nandun na siya.
And June Reyes and Olsen Brasella could not help you anymore at that point. Okay. 42-39 is the tally here. 3 minutes and 48 to go. But I really feel that no matter what size you are, you really have to develop all the possible skills that you can develop in a basketball game. Adukul muffs the free throw. 42-39 is still the count with 3 minutes and 42 to play here in the second quarter. Manila has more turnovers here in this second period. 5 against 4. Capobres inches in closer, but look at this. Calagio gets it whatever which way.
And San Juan is inching in closer to that lead. Just a 1-point lead by the Manila Metro Stars. And Manila, they have stopped their fast break attack here in the second quarter.
They're not running, you're correct. San Juan people yelling defense, defense. Under the basket we go, but to no avail. Maedihoya! Like an aggressive cat. In the meantime, San Juan trying to ride on the crest of a 14-5 run. That ball is loose. It goes nowhere. Here comes Dimape. Lead pass to Martin, who has to crouch low for it, but unable to handle it. Dimape had the right thing in mind, though. This is tight. This is close. This is the conference finals here in the North. We'll have more of it in just a short while. Sam Sarmenta alongside Danny Francisco. Speaking of Danny, he'll try to break down some of the plays that we've observed in the course of this first 24 minutes. We're down to the final, 2-45. 1-point lead by Manila. Suddenly, may bagong second win ang San Juan dito sa second quarter, Danny.
At nagpapakita sila ng pagiging agresibo. No, wala si Chris Calagio. So yung mga ibang manlalaro, talaga nagpapakita rin.
And Kalani gets the bucket that pushes San Juan in front, 43-42. Maybe the visuals of San Juan, or Negros rather, celebrating earlier, inspiring the Knights to get back into business here. It's Longalong. Capobre says, what are you doing? Let me take this away from you. Rivas Calagio thinking three. Yes! And suddenly the Knights have not been exactly pleasing guests here on the home court of the Metro Stars. They now have climbed to a 4-point lead and Compton has to give up the foul. Now Manila is in a long, long silence. Only 5 points in the last 6 minutes. And San Juan now with its biggest lead of the ball game, 47-42. Tagal na pa ako ng Manila doon sa 42, ha?
At ito si Alex Compton, sigurado sa bubuga dito, going to the last 1 minute and 50 of the first half. Problem is this, a second unit also being used by the Manila Metro Stars, save for Peter Martin, Alex Compton.
Here's Richie Ang, who had a great performance in game number 3. In the meantime, we have a foul away from the ball.
Oh,
Pereira committing that foul, his first, and 16 fouls now work against the Knights. And Compton will be on the line. Go ahead, please.
Yung susi dito sa pagbabantay kay Alex Compton, kung wala siyang bola sa kanyang kamay, eh, huwag mo talagang didikitan. Because ang ginagawa ni Alex Compton, he moves around without the ball just to one, initiate a possible screen for a teammate, or to look for an opening for himself.
Takes care of that free throw. Anytime you do not do anything when you do not have the ball, nakatayo ka lang, you're a liability to your team. And Alex Compton, of course, is the antithesis with that. He is such an excellent player who moves well without the ball. You know, when I was growing up, the player that I liked doing that, I don't know if you remember that, Danny, see, John Havlicek. John Havlicek of the Boston Celtics. Hindi pinapawisan sa game yun. Takbo lang ng takbo. And he would create openings for himself, and the guards would just find him open. Here's Rivas. Uh-oh! Smothered, but there's a whistle. Manila's been hurt by 8 turnovers in the course of the second quarter. And San Juan has scored 13 points off those 8 turnovers. Complete. I think our writers hit it right on the top of the nail when they said a reversal of fortunes. And I think this is happening now to the other team, to Manila, in the course of the second quarter. Calagio makes it a 6-point lead, a repeat of the largest enjoyed by San Juan in the game so far. Richie Ang attacks, but Manila has now committed its 9th turnover. Suddenly, Manila falling apart here.
Again, who do you go to? You've got to go to Alex Compton just to set up the play. Kailangan bigay sa guardia. Si Richie Ang, nakita niya, libre. Yung problema ito. Hindi handa si Chandler Donaldson na tanggapin yung pasa ni Richie Ang. San Juan is just making Manila play the game that they are not used to playing.
Good point. Here's McDonald De Hoya. Look inside now by Danny Capobres. Outside. Christian Calagio pops from 15, ribbing out. Alex Compton is pushed away. And Alex Compton, as sporting as ever, does not argue the point. Manages to conserve a lot of energy that he needs. Calagio, illegal defense against Manila. Somebody switching late.
Si Jun Morano, matatawagan ng illegal defense.
6-point lead by the Knights. Yes, you heard me right. Make that a 9-point lead. Calagio with an explosion here. He now has 14 points anchored on 2 Islander connections. And Manila says timeout. Suddenly, it's a 9-point lead as this 30-second timeout is requested. Rubicon Buhay and Dugo Buhay ang Lakas. 39.4 seconds. They've only added just 2 points. So the silence, too deafening as far as Manila is concerned.
And suddenly, ang San Juan, kumawala ng ilang puntos rin yun.
Yes.
14 yata yun.
And Naki De Hoya with the knee foul. That will now be the 17th foul of the Knights and will send Demape to the line for a 1-on-1 chance.
You know, despite the foul given up by Maki De Hoya, the intention of San Juan to switch was there in the two-man game played by Ibet Demape. Problem is, in that two-man game, pagka nagkaroon ng switching, halos pantay lang ang height advantage ng San Juan dahil si Ferreria ang nakikipag-switch. Ang kumukuha naman kay Ibet Demape, matangkad rin si Maki De Hoya.
I'm sure in the mind now of Gilbert Demape saying, ngayon ako gagawa, huwag naman tayong madudulas dito sa game na ito. This is my best scoring spree in the 4 games so far. Demape now in double digits with 10. Second leading scorer for Manila after Alex Compton. 7-point lead nonetheless for the visiting Knights. Leading the series 2-1. Capobres to De Hoya. Calagio. Give and go to De Hoya. I don't think they expected De Hoya to go for the basket. Thompson quickly across. Let's fly a three. Top angle. Adugal throws it up. But San Juan back in business. Ahead by 9:55 to 46. We'll have halftime, Danny, and so much more when we return. Already the first possession, it belonged to San Juan, but they threw the ball away on the inbound and Manila obtaining possession. Now, Manila has been strong in the second half. That has been the character, the trait of this team over the last 3 years. That shot is gone. It's nowhere close. Maki De Hoya decides to shoot. Glass shot!
Remember, we were talking about Bonel Balingat giving some respect to Romelu Adugal. Well, Romelu Adugal must give some respect to Maki De Hoya in terms of giving up a shot like that.
Because, alam mo si Maki doesn't take too many, but he, when he shoots, he usually scores in them. De Hoya keeping Adugal busy, and now the 15 points, 15-point level, yun yung pinag-uusapan ni Rhea nung kanyang ulat kanila. That is the objective na gustong abutin ng Manila, but maybe that's the way they can get into this ball game, get back in fact, by limiting the output of San Juan. Alex Thompson, long distance call home, too far out on that particular try, but Alex has hit that before. In the meantime, a foul on this sequence.
Danny Capobres is guilty of that personal foul number two against him.
And we take a look at some of the numbers of the opening 24 minutes, Danny.
You know, the field goal percentage, we wanted to show this because 52%, that's a very high clip. No,
yes.
That's a three-point shooting na San Juan, 40% as compared to only 12% by the Manila Metro Stars. And to think Manila attempted more than the San Juan Knights in terms of assists. Alam mo yung reversal of fortune sa pinakita natin ngayon, talagang parang nag-reverse ulit, no? 16 assists for the San Juan Knights against Manila's 9. The turnovers may be the same, but the turnover points are significantly different in favor of the San Juan Knights, as well as the fast break points there.
As Manila had the edge in that department in the third game, 13-21. Ferreira, it will not bounce in. Martin has a hand on it, but a loose ball foul spotted. Now let's check on the team that's leading right now with JC Gonzalez in this Advil courtside update.
All right, thanks guys. As the Knights made their way back into the dugout to start the second half, what Coach Philip told them was, guys, what's important here is we start and play the second half with the same intensity we ended the first half with. If we ride that momentum, we can win this game definitely. And one defensive adjustment you might want to watch out for here in the second half is the two-man game of Manila, especially involving Compton and Adugal. Usually what happens here is Compton with Adugal is able to establish a very good solid screen somewhere bandas at by three-point line. So what Coach Philip wants him to do is particularly Rivas and De Hoya, whoever is guarding Romel Adugal, to push him out and body him out so that should Compton get free, there's time for his man to adjust and catch up with him. Guys, back to you.
Thanks a lot, JC, for the Advil courtside update. No pick and roll on that sequence. Simply Alex Compton determined to drill in that three. He already has collected his second. By the way, keep in mind he scored 6 of 8 in game number 3. Inside we go with Rivas. And Rivas becoming an active participant in the offense.
And Capobres having that vision from the weak side cut of Rafi Rivas.
Rivas with a 5-point collection. It's a 10-point game, 9 minutes and 43 to go. As we continue to report to you live from the mainland more here in San Andres. Here's Brown swiftly over to Compton. Compton applies the brakes. Pereira watching him closely. Compton quick release. That one is a little bit too long. Rebound in the hands of Calagio. Calagio was beginning to simmer in that second period. Collected 10 of his 14 points there. Capobres trying to be patient. Double team clamps down on him. And a foul could be on Capobres as he tried to regain possession and a bit of pride in that situation.
Pagkaparating na yung double team, kailangan nakikita na ni Danny Capobres. There is a quick adjustment on the part of Chandler Donaldson to pick up Rafi Rivas to prevent him from going in for a cut. But you know, there's a report in JC Gonzalez, no? On the floor right now, Alex Compton is pushing his three-point baskets because he cannot seem to get a guy who can give him one firm pick because Romelu Adugal is not in the equation
yes,
at this point.
Yes, bumaba na siya ngayon eh. But just to go back to yung kay Capobes, don't you feel whenever na-i-stealan ka, just a bit red in the face? Every time, masapal ka, sabihin mo, okay lang yan, play on. Then, sakit-chan. In the meantime, Victulero collects his second personal foul. 9 minutes and a second remaining. 10-point lead by the San Juan Knights, who are hoping to send the series over to some kind of vacation into Sugarlandia. The format reveals that if San Juan wins today, regardless if we have a game on Wednesday, if San Juan wins, let's start with that. We begin on November 11th, Saturday. It will start in San Juan if San Juan wins. So ang home court advantage will belong to San Juan. It's a 2-3-2 format. In the meantime, Balingit with his third foul.
You know, it looked like Chandler Donaldson took Bonel Balingit down. Iyayakap na niya si Bonel Balingit. Pero natawagan si Bonel Balingit.
And this is exactly what Philip Cesar is trying to point out to the official.
Mahirap kasi tawagan yan because unang-una nakaposisyon na si Bonel Balingit. Siya na nga nakauna dito. And I felt that that foul could have gone to Chandler Donaldson himself.
And as life would have it, Danny, yung second motion lang yung nakikita. Capobres runner, oh, just out! And what is this whistle going to be on? In the meantime, ball game at 59-49, 8:38 to go. Manila Faithful, they have been quiet for so long, way back at the fourth minute of the second quarter. Long scoring spree by San Juan, long silence by Manila. Capobres is hijacked as the second stick by painstakingly one by one. Calagio snaps on a turnaround. It will not connect. Rivas says hello. Victulero, Capobres straight. And two!
And you've got to credit the effort being shown by Rafi Rivas. It came from one side to swipe the ball away from the other side.
And Capobres already with 10 points, second leading scorer for the San Juan Knights, who are in high gear. Victulero, however, trying to establish some firm control over the ball. Peter Martinez hounding him no end. They consumed a lot of time in the backcourt. Bonel Balingit wants to waltz with everybody. Alex Gonta collects number three. Now the size factor beginning to tell here. Not only in terms of the number of rebounds, it's just the ability to grab the ball.
You know, the problem for Manila right now is that they are not playing at the same level that they normally play a third quarter. Hindi sila pwede mag-trade ng baskets. They've got to even try to run their fast breaks. Remember, Sev, we talked about their fast breaks na pipigilan dahil doon sa San Juan. They have been challenging whatever long passes Manila would issue.
Meantime, Balingit now going 2 out of 3 from the free throw line. Can't nail the second. Already 7 points scored by San Juan. 7:39 to go. Metro Stars have some talking to do. They've fallen behind here by 13. We'll be back.
They know that they've gotten this 13-point lead, and Manila has to explode or double time their efforts in trying to grab the lead back.
I don't have the numbers to help me out as Martin mocks that attempted slam. He was going for the jugular there. Rivas scores! But you know, San Juan is a team that knows how to manage a sizable lead. Rhea, let's go to you for the simple reason that Manila isn't battled right now as you check out this FedEx Fastlane. Go ahead, Rhea.
Yes, well, Sev, one thing is for sure, they're not helping themselves in the sense that they're starting to press the panic buttons, and that's a big no-no for Coach Boise Samar and his coaching staff. Everybody wants to score, and that just can't be. I was telling you guys earlier that he's subscribing to the philosophy of giving his players the freedom to do what they want, but now he has totally trashed that, and he's realizing that his players need more guidance. They want somebody to tell them what to do. So on offense, this is what he wants to see. He wants to see more picks and rolls. He wants to see Alex Compton drive, get the fouls, and he also wants to see spot-up shooters like Joel Ko and Demape and Brown out there in the perimeter, guys.
Exactly, Rhea. And what happened in that first half, they want to recall that, Danny, but it's not happening. Yes.
And the big question mark for the Minamoto Stars right now is that, are they beginning to question themselves? You cannot do that, because once you do that, you begin to press the panic button. You know, I only coach Boise Samar.
Rivas. And Adugo tries to yank it away from Capobres. The Metro Stars will obtain possession via the privilege arrow, which is now pointing in their direction.
You know, Seth, San Juan has been challenging every rebound, and that has stopped also the opportunity for Manila to go on a fast break.
Danny, the only points of Manila in this third quarter were those 3 points thrown by Alex Compton. And 5 minutes have gone by. Boise Samar in a quandary right now. His team simply falling apart here. Shot clock at 13. Here's Adugo. Compton trying to wiggle open. Victoletto, his former teammate, just wise to that motion. But you can't stop Compton once he wants it. From a high of 15, it's now down to 12. Compton is the only one who has scored for Manila in the period. All the 6 points of Manila, courtesy of their ace, Alex Compton, and a steal. Lead pass to Brown, counter steal.
And then it's Rafa Rivas.
Rivas is doing so many things defensively, actually.
The smaller things, actually, that is helping their team.
Alagio checks the shot clock. Alagio. Christian Calagio on the line. Production total, 14 points. All of them still in that first half. Christian now 3 of 3 from the strike. So much better from the free throw line by San Juan this afternoon. Calagio now going 4 of 4. Approaching now the midway point of the third. Again, keep in mind, the hunt continues, the search continues for an opponent for Negros. Joel Co has had some problems handling the ball. Knights obtained possession. Co, of course, trying to claim that he was held onto. It's just that San Juan has his number.
Yeah. At kahit paano, kikita mo, no? Papapakin ng San Juan yan. And
papapakin.
Chances are, Sev, yung mga ganito mga clips, no, doon mo makikita who wants it more. No? Katulad nun, there were three red shirts ganging up on Joel Co.
I think San Juan just so interested in meeting Negros and getting Negros over to their court come next Saturday. But Manila will have to come up with a response to extend the series to keep it at least on northern soil, at least up to Wednesday. And Calagio now busting open. He has 18 points. Matching his total in game number two, in which he also delivered the winning bucket. Ang, dribbling through the maze, got a foul. Capobres with his fourth. And now San Juan has its biggest lead at 68-52. Danny, the theme of reversal of fortune, so apropos.
Grabe yung pinapakita ng San Juan Knights dito, no? But the point being is the third quarter is supposed to be a very strong quarter for the Manila Metro Stars. Alex Compton has been showing himself up here in the third quarter. The problem is, hindi sumusunod yung mga ibang manlalaro, yung mga ibang kakampi niya. Seven, the pressure on Alex Compton is just so enormous that only 6 points by the Manila Metro Stars, and all of which have come from Alex Compton.
Just keeping you up to date on the free throws. Manila now shooting 13 of 19, San Juan 12 of 19. 5 minutes and 25 in the balance. And Co and Calagio are interested in ballroom dancing. They have been talking to each other, and they have each been warned for taunting. Now a double foul.
Well, this will not benefit the Manila Metro Stars. You cannot lose your head in a game like this. I saw Alex Compton signaling to his teammates, we've got to use our heads.
And he's been doing that exactly while he was talking to Broderick Toledo. Pops, his confidence growing with every passing minute. In the meantime, and a Manila foul. Joel Co. Mukhang flavor of the man siya na San Juan, ano ha? Into the hands of Aducol. And here come the Knights. Inside, Rivas, the hook.
Ang lumalabas pa nga ngayon, na tinatakbuhan ng San Juan, itong Manila Metro Stars. Alex Compton really having a very difficult time trying to initiate and orchestrate the plays for his team. They are down by 18.
And a timeout to talk things over. Brought out their placards. They've been shouting at the top of their lungs, and a vital statistic is on your screen.
Well, the inside points hurting the Manila Metro Stars. They cannot seem to get some mileage off of Romel Aducol, unlike the Knights, who managed to get 24 points from the outside and the inside. 34 big points. Pati yung free throw shooting ng Manila. Well, actually, both teams, they are faltering sa kanilang free throws.
In the inside points, and on that statistic, it was something that San Juan used to the hilt in game one when they outscored Manila 54-38. It was equal in game two at 46 apiece. Manila had the edge there, 42-38 in game three. But here you saw the difference. Even the free throw shooting has improved for San Juan here. I guess when it rains, it does pour. But Manila, they have 4 minutes to go in this particular quarter, Danny. What's on the agenda? What should you do? I think it's a defensive chore more than anything else.
Yes, they've got to stop the offense of the San Juan Knights. Not more than that, they have to keep their heads above them, their shoulders. That's going to be number four against Alex Compton. Bad news, because Alex Compton has the whole 6 points of the Manila Metro Stars in this quarter. Manila, definitely sabihin na natin ng alat yung kanilang opensa.
Exactly.
Very unlikely for Manila to do that.
You know, Rhea, as we go to you for this Advil courtside update, Boise Samar has tried the X's and the O's. He's tried the emotional pitch. What was left in that last timeout?
Well, I think what was left for him to do as a coach was to give his boys a little hope. The problem of Manila, Sev, is that they have not been able to settle down. And Boise Samar told his players that they are forcing their shots. They're not being patient on offense. But his little ray of light there was the fact that this is still the third quarter. And time can still be on their side if they let it be so. And what he wants them to do now is take advantage of the fact that San Juan is in penalties. They just play tough defense. Sev, Danny?
Thanks a lot. Now, as Rhea was speaking, I could not help but notice, maybe, just maybe, while Rhea was underscoring the phrase ray of hope, I get the feeling that Manila is waiting for Compton to explode. Then they will start, but I don't think that is going to happen yet.
You know, that happened during the first quarter when Compton exploded for 5 straight points after opening tip-off. Problem is, sumunod yung mga manlalaro, no, ng Manila Metro Stars. They played well, even the second unit, prompting Coach Philip Cesar to say na, guys, it's the second unit who's killing us in the first quarter. Now, here in the second half, kailangan tuloy-tuloy ang laro, no? Whether you're the second unit, you're the first unit, like Peter Martin, nakikita mo yung bench ng Manila Metro Stars. Problem is, Compton, once he gets shot down, and you must remember, Compton is nursing 4 personal fouls, they will have to look for the rest of the guys, like Romel Aducol.
Ang forced to skip it outside, but look at Rivas doing everything on the floor. Kicks it outside. Vic Culera says, thank you! Thank you! One of the best shooting guards in the NBA, no question. Vic Culero with a 10-point collection. Keep in mind, he played backup for Alex Compton in the first year of the NBA. Richie Ang will get the rest. Now, Alex Compton really drenched in sweat here.
Pagod na rin ito si Alex Compton. At alam mo ba, Seve, masasabi rin natin na Manila is a team that thrives on the guard rotation, no? Because the guard rotation will initially dictate the kind of game that the front line will have.
Correct.
Especially during their two-man game, yung ganyan, no? ang nangyayari ngayon is that pressure is just so much on Alex Quanton that the rest of the guys are rendered useless. Even the front line of Manila is rendered useless.
3:54 to go, third quarter, 73-55. Manila limited to 9 points. Dasha has a good attack at the basket, just can't get it to go through. Chuchu Serrano driving hard against Bonel Balingit. Complete mismatch there. But you know, Chuchu Serrano, he's not afraid of anybody in the box.
Gusto yata ni Coach Boy si Samar magkaroon ng that, you know, that simple spark plug. Sabihin na natin, ano, na, we have to use our speed against the much taller San Juan Knights.
73-56. 17 points. Biggest lead at 19. Serrano now hitting 4 of 6 from the charity stripe. Now, if you're Manila, the common dictum, gospel, is cut it down to a tired expression of a manageable lead. Alcantara says, I have other plans. Dasha can't get it to go through, but Manila is interested in manageable leads. Here's Brown. Ko is begging for it. Ko wants to shoot from three, but decides to court the inside. He will make it.
Just down to 14 points.
And Philip Cesar says, why did you give the baseline? He's scratching his forehead, and a timeout is taken. We'll be back. Oh, baka naman tinamaan. Nasa Davao ba kami yung kaibigan mo?
Oo, si Willie Torres. Willie, magpagaling ka na lang.
Okay, ang hindi magkakatubig sa tuhod, kundi nabasa dahil nag-ayos ng flat kanina, si JC Gonzalez na lang ang puntahan natin.
Oh, yun nga yung ayaw mangyari ni Philip Cesar sa team nila. Ayaw niya ma-flat tire. They're going so, things are going so well for them. Now what he told them, guys, 14-point lead, that's nothing. Just goes to show how much respect Philip Cesar has for the Manila Metro Stars. Goes, guys, hindi natin pwedeng pabaan tong lead na to sa 10 points kasi kung mag-start fourth quarter, 10 points, mayayari tayo ng Manila Metro Stars. Guys, back to you.
And suddenly, it's a 30-second timeout. Suddenly, a bit of disarray as far as San Juan is concerned as we go into this Revicon Buhayan to go Buhayan Lakas timeout. Still a 14-point lead. Large is at 19. Philip Cesar is the right thing in mind. You do not want to light the fire under the Metro Stars because they can be most lethal as Dasha with a mismatch against Serrano in terms of height, busting open.
Manila may want to make use of speed, pero in terms of height, itong San Juan ay talaga namamayanin dito sa third quarter, Sev.
Serrano lobs it over to Compton. Compton trying to beat Rodriguez with a dribble. The dish off to Brown. Brown is crowded, and suddenly the entire defensive line collapsing on him. Here's Calagio, pushes it hard. Time down to 2 minutes and 13 seconds. And Victor Leros, waltzing on the baseline, decides to pass it outside. Shot clock down to 13. Inside we go.
And a foul had to be given up by Joel Koh.
And earlier today, Negros winning 93-68 to end the series 3-1 against the Cebu Gems. Gilbert Dimape, who seems to have been a forgotten man in this third quarter, gets the call from Boise Samar. Joel Koh will sit down.
You know, I still would like to gamble on some big men on the part of the Manila Metro Stars. For two plays now, ibinababa nila sa low post. Una kay Bruce Dasha, at ngayon kay Omanci Rodriguez, who converts his two free throws.
Total of 4 points already, whereas it could have been 4 points in their favor. Possibly. Lead is restored to 18. Hardly manageable going into the fourth, Danny. Compton, however, playing his heart out. Vic Tolero pops. Vic Tolero just rubbing salt on the wounds of Manila right now.
That's 12 points for Chito Vic Tolero, and he just really knows how to run the fast break. This is a whopping 20-point lead by the San Juan Knights.
And it is the biggest, that whopping 20-point lead as Aduko spins, scores. That's it down to 18 with 1:25 to go. Dishoff, Rodriguez, Dasha. Vic Tolero. Calagio. Calagio spinning, knocking it in.
And everything seems to be falling for the San Juan Knights. Alam mo, Seb, napaka-crucial na meron kang Chito Vic Tolero on the floor. No? Somehow, it eases off the pressure of a Chris Calagio to do everything for the team.
Vic Tolero already with 12 points, 7 assists, and 4 rebounds. Who could ask for anything more from Chito Vic Tolero here? But the game far from over as Maki De Hoya commits this third foul.
He's at the free throw line. But that's not the normal case of a Romelu Dugal. You would like to get the ball to him when he's within about 5 feet, no, yung range na yun, para maka-hook shot sa man lang.
46 seconds to play. Adukol nails both charities. 12 points by Romelu Dugal. Matching his output yesterday in game 3. Keep in mind that San Juan is out of 30s to call. Joel Cross says good night. Sixth foul. And it will send the Knights into the 2 free throw penalty bonus. Well, you know, I'm taking a look at the Metro Stars right now. Their focus is here, there, and everywhere. I'm looking at the bench. This is more at no other time than now when they have to get it together. And, you know, their championship, their crown slowly just slipping away from their head right now. I know a fourth quarter is still in the offing. But they will have to make something happen quickly at the top of the fourth. Because San Juan is not interested in coming, going to San Juan to meet Manila, but in meeting Negros come Saturday. Peter Martin, however, has other plans. Calagio. In the meantime, Manila rushing. Alex Compton, 3. In and out. Adukol goes up. No buzzer beater. Boise Samar just begging for a foul. Just trying to rev up the troops more than anything else. Anyway, we'll be back for the fourth.
...18 points in the second, only 21 in the third. And that 21 points, you know, they could not have hit that, no? Were it not for the awakening going to the last 4 minutes.
Actually, kasi for the longest time, yung 6 points ni Alex Compton, yun lang ang tanging na itala ng Metro Stars.
Ang tagal nun.
Tagal.
And a foul given up by Maki De Hoya to start the fourth quarter. That's going to be number 4 against De Hoya.
Alam mo, Manila had the right thing in mind. They were trying to chase, cut down the lead. I know the target was just about 10 going into the fourth. That's the common gospel. But, you know, San Juan said, ha-ha, yan ang gagawin nyo. Tinapakan nila yung gas pedal. O, sige. Okay, JC, San Juan is 12 minutes or just 11:46 away from a date with Negros. What is in their minds?
Well, funny you mentioned that, Sev. Exacto nga sinabi Coach Philip Cesar. Guys, 12 minutes lang kailangan natin po. He goes, oh, just a few reminders before we enter the fourth quarter. He goes, I don't want them to go on any kind of run courtesy of Alex Compton. He goes, bayaan mo yung mga ibang shooters tumira. Importantly, ayoko si Compton na mag 3-point shot and ayoko si Compton na maging hot this quarter. Guys, back to you.
Sabi ni Philip Cesar, respetado ko si Alex Compton pero ayoko sa kanya sa mga araw na ito. Because ang buhay nitong team na ito nakasalalay doon sa mamang ang pangalan ay Alex Compton, number 44.
Alam mo, crucial rin itong opening minutes. No? The first 3 minutes of every quarter for me is crucial in the sense that it can control and dictate the tempo of that quarter alone.
Philip Cesar, kahit nakaupo, no? Actively following every... Parang pa rin siya nung naglalaro siya.
Actually, ito si Coach Philip Cesar. Nagulat ako sa kanyang outfit ngayon. May rubber shoes. I think it also... Psychologically...
Baka may uniform na San Juan dyan, ha? Yan.
Parang pinapakita niya sa kanyang malalaro. Lalaban tayo. Kung kahit na ako, maglaro. Maglalaro ako.
Pare, kung gusto niyo sa ilalim tayo pa. Vice Mayor Philip Cesar, of course. The young history of this team, possibility of them going into the national finals. Of course, keep in mind, they've already won the crossover. But Manila, just staying in the thick of things. Hoping that this fourth quarter will be different. Nanlamig, Danny. Ano? Oh, talaga grabe. Nanlamig. Split from the line.
Alam mo, there's a term in basketball na lagi natin ginagamit, no? But it aptly described the Manila Metro Stars. They lost the fluidity of their game during the third quarter.
Which they have tried to recover. They're trying to do that now. Calagio has a shot. But there's an offensive foul downstairs. Alam mo si Kaldani Ferreira, yung mga... I know there's a lot of shoving, pushing, jockeying for position. Kaso, he gives the referee an opportunity to use the whistle.
May kita eh. May kita ito. Dahil para sa akin, ito malalarong to. He has a lot of flailing arms, so to speak, pagka nag-dribble. Maybe it's a natural tendency to guard the ball, pero yung problema, pagka may contact, natatawagan siya ng referee.
Yes.
Might be a good time to bring back Chito Victolero into the ballgame.
Very eager itong young man ito to get the possession, ano ha? Traveling. Pamela Ducol just laughs it off. Yun, ayun, 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 ayun sa baba. Cha-cha-cha-cha-cha. Cool yun. 10:50 to go. 17-point lead. Oh, big flight that time by Dasha. Couldn't hang on to the ball. Serrano is fouled. And again, it's Ferreria.
That's going to be number five against Ferreria.
San Juan's fourth team foul.
Puts them in early penalty because after a foul given up by San Juan, it's going to be a one-on-one situation for Manila. And that might be the opening that Manila needs because it stops the clock. It gives them a lot of free throws, but they have to convert.
Now, Ferreira is really taking to heart the instructions of Philip Cesar. Ayokong si Compton makatangal ang bola. No rally, no run. Sparked by their ace, Martin. And Rafi Rivas has a little of everything. Five rebounds by Rivas. Look at the tentacles. Hard at work. Ferreira contributes. Point lead. No rally in sight for the Metro Stars.
No pass breaks in sight for the Manila Metro Stars, and that's the only thing that can bring them back into this game.
Because San Juan is not allowing them to get any rebounds, any loose balls. That's not going to click. Alam ko, no, madaling sabihin, malayo pa ito, but you know, Manila will have to do something. Get points in bundles here. Alex Compton blocking the shot of Dasha. Alex knows they need him.
Yun na, nakikita mo si Alex, eh, no? Hinahanap niya yung fast break. Pass, wala siya mapasahan talaga. Eh.
Demape with his fourth foul, and you know, suddenly Manila looks like a very tired team on the floor.
And if you compare them to the players of San Juan on the floor, it looks like, again, when you hit that comfort level, ano, yung pawis mo is yung natural na pawis na lumalabas because you do not exert a lot of extra effort. For the Manila Metro Stars, just looking at Alex Compton, he's just kumbaga zapped, no, of all the energy.
Good point, good observation. And Calagio, look at him run. Tino yung takbo niya. It's a confident stride. He knows this game is theirs to be taken. Biggest lead now at 22. Serrano pops and connects. Yeah. This 90 points is the biggest that has been registered by San Juan in the series. Make that 92 right now. So far, the biggest they were able to score was on game one. In game one, 85-72 was the count then when they won against Manila. Here's Martin. No shot in sight.
Execution has been the problem of the Manila Metro Stars here in the second half. And it's beginning to show. And hindi sila natatawagan ng 23-second violation ng basta-basta, sir.
Yes, indeed. And the San Juan faithful beginning to sense that maybe their Knights could emerge as Northern Conference champions. And checking the banners here, of course, there's one. Manila was the Northern Conference champion last year and the national champion last year. But that crown, those crowns now hang precariously on their heads. As maybe there may be a new champion in town unless something drastic, dramatic happens in the next 2 minutes. Kalani.
Alam mo, parang laro to nung Negro Cebu eh. No, kahit na ano, ipukol lang San Juan, ipapasok.
And Romel Aducol, is that the same injury? You wonder. No, it looks like cramps. Nakakatayo siya, no? Metro Stars will utilize the timeout, down by 24 with 8:04 to go. And somebody from San Juan, flying with no passport, entering the court, I think it was an assistant coach, who has been issued a technical. No, sinasabi ng San Juan, we don't need that right now, you know.
We're up by 23. Yes. We don't want to lose our focus going to the last 8 minutes. Dahil itong Manila is quick to take advantage of that, those kinds of opportunities. Yes.
Compton. Run is nowhere inside. Compton so far with just 1 point in the fourth quarter. Calagio sets for an Islander three. Points, biggest output. Rhea, the champions of the NBA, slowly their crown slipping from their heads right now.
Oh, yes, Seven, and they know it. You just have to look at the bench to realize what they're feeling. They just have so many problems right now, but again, Boise Salvador is taking it, you know, one step at a time, trying to focus on the little things. Didn't talk about offense. He wants to talk about their defense because he knows that's where the offense will come from. Seven, Danny.
Thanks a lot, Rhea. And you know, Alemoyan playing defense when you're down by as large as it is. Now it's 26, the biggest lead of the game. Parang bumibigat ang paa mo.
Bumibigat na yung paa mo. At more than anything else, of defending the offense of the San Juan Knights, we've got to make mention of the fact that the offense of some of the players on the Manila Metro Stars camp have been missing, like Jun Longalong, his inside penetrations, AC Brown, pati na rin si Richie Ang, who had a great game three. Nowhere to be found in this game. Ibet Demape came out to play. Alex Compton is giving it his all here. Hindi lang sumusunod yung mga iba.
Yes. And it's not coming together. Calagio, on the other hand, superlative performance, 26 points. Still 7 minutes to go. Demape brushing aside Dasha. Demape scores. He has 12. Rodriguez, Rivas. Rivas jumping up and down, but ball going nowhere. And Rodriguez could not resist the temptation.
And you could see Coach Philip Cesar.
Pare.
You don't want to give up those fouls because, one, you committed a mistake. You cannot correct your mistake by adding a foul. That's going to be number three against Amancio Rodriguez.
If
Kasi ang gumagawa niyan dati, nung sa mga kakampi niya, si Bernard Pabiose, yung mga tapik-tapik na gano'n. But Bernard could do that kasi maliit siya,
maliit
no?
Siya.
Ang hirap po na to, Alman, to suddenly stoop down and...
Kaya nga sabi nga nila, no, magkamali ka man sa isang laro, no, during the game, during the course of the game, you may want to make it up by playing defense, the other things that will help your team.
I think Philip Cesar has used every available body on his bench here today. And everybody has contributed something.
They have delivered, yes.
Yes, everybody has scored. Of course, Wilmer Bañares still nursing an injury. He's over there. But so far, everybody who has been sent dispatched onto the floor has contributed at least 2 points. Calagio goes airborne, but ball is batted away. 3 seconds remain on the shot clock.
You know, should San Juan win this game and move on to the national finals, Sev, I'd like to discuss a point with you later on after this timeout.
Yes, sir.
But Manila has also gotten burned out. Just like the Cebu Gems during the Intracon finals and their semi-final stint moving on to this national finals or the conference finals, eh, maaaring pagod na rin ba itong Manila Metro Stars?
That's a significant point when you consider the big run that Manila had to do to get into
get
the
back.
Finals of the Intracon, while San Juan, they didn't do too well in the Intracon. They already had the advantage of winning the crossover. Makabaon na sila.
Waiting pa sila.
Yes.
Katulad ng Negro Slashers, no? The Negro Slashers just waited and you know, they executed very well. Everybody on the bench played well for the Negro Slashers.
They were so rested that they could afford to buck the absence of John Ferriol.
John Ferriol, yes.
And everybody stepping up like Batog and Sid White. And, you know, this is still down to 5 and 55. But with the way the game has gone, as Capobres knocks that one in, this particular victory and... They are five minutes away. Alex Compton was in front of his electric fan. Bent over, really, and literally gasping for air.
So it's going to be a one-on-one situation now for the Manila Metro Stars.
You know, the torrents came as early as the second quarter, 55-46. San Juan emerged on top at the end of the first half, although Manila was leading at the end of the first quarter, 28-21. Manila led by as much as 10, but that impasse, that long portion wherein Manila could not score, and suddenly there was a 15-4 run by the San Juan Knights, nothing working for Manila.
You know, that 15-4 run, Sev, if I remember right, did not come from one person alone. Nope. From the San Juan Knights. It came from different angles, from the guard rotation, from the wingman in Chris Calagio, even Rafi Rivas getting to the act.
And Chito Victulera has done a masterful job of running the ship. Sa akin personally, partner, nung nakapag-give and go kay Maki De Hoya. You know, Maki De Hoya is not an offensive threat. Suddenly finds himself open. Do not allow Maki De Hoya to get that opening because yung mga bihirang maka-score, i-score yan.
Oo, at malaking tulong na rin na ibigay ni Bruce Dasa sa kanyang koponan.
And Alex Compton's late game rally is not, looks like it's not coming.
It's not falling at all. He has missed a few attempts at the three-point shot. He's going to go to the free throw line. Sev, remember Bruce Dasa, he was scoring when Chris Calagio fell silent. Biglang nung nawala naman si Bruce Dasa, yun na, nag-umpisa na naman si Chris Calagio. So it's very difficult to go up against a team wherein everybody on the bench is contributing.
24 big point advantage. 24 point big advantage, that is, as Compton now hits 7 of 7 from the free throw line. Sabi na San Juan, sana bumilis yung relo.
Because with 5 minutes left, a short run might get or might throw San Juan into some sort of panic at baka bumigay pa to San Juan. But at the rate they're shooting that basketball, eh halos lahat pumapasok eh.
Is Victorero trying to set up. And what you want when you have a lead like this is to make good decisions, spread the floor, take good shots, like that one. And look at this. 103-79. This 24-point refrain has been, distance has been a familiar refrain. That's what we wanted to say. We'll be back. And then it was Cebu winning it back in the second year, going into the national finals last year. Ajukol with a long distance connection leads down to 22. 4:38 to go. Only thing not working for Manila at this juncture is the time. Dalagio checks the timepiece. 4:20 to go. Capobras fighting for it. Here's Martin. And Ajukol drops to the deck. The Mapi shot will not work, and Ajukol takes time in getting himself up. And Ajukol takes a long time in getting up. Alam mo ito, halong cramps, halong fatigue.
Pagod na rin ito si Romelu, no? Saka, it hasn't been an eventful season for him. He has gotten some injuries also.
Correct, oo. Lalo na yung most outstanding pitch kay John Montalvo, no, ng Cebu.
Oo.
They got entangled. Romelu missing game two of the Intercon Finals, which was eventually won by Cebu. And we're down to only 3 minutes and 55 seconds.
Grabe itong shooting clip ng San Juan Knights. They are 8 out of 14 from the field here in the fourth quarter, Sev.
Victorero. Rivas. Maximal Islander 3. Well, that's the way the cookie crumbles and the ball bounces. And this one looks like San Juan is well on its way. Now, they will have an entire week to prepare. That is going to be the interesting part. I pity the guy who will have to review all the tapes all over again. And that's part of the job here. But one thing that San Juan will have to find extremely interesting is how Negros has played inspired basketball without a John Filios. You know, it seemed that all the cards were in the favor of Cebu. Compton can't nail anything. And he knows it.
He knows it. At itong San Juan, eh, talagang gagatasin nila yung oras, ano?
And at the end of this ball game, we will have a few items that we'd like to check off in our agenda. We'd just like to introduce our Erickson Choice player. Yours? Yes, there are two. And there's the banner being unfurled. And the Northern Conference title slowly slipping away from the Manila Metro Stars. It's an eventful 1999 for the Metro Stars, simply because they won almost every title in sight, including the Southeast Asian Games title in Brunei Darussalam. But this year has been a different season altogether, a struggle. They lost a key player in Don Tomaso, lost Louis Alas also. And so many different things happening, but Manila managed to the eternal credit of Boise Samar, the team managed to bounce back during the latter portion of the Intercon Challenge. But take nothing away from San Juan, this young ball club, now just in their second year,
already stepping into the national finals as we move into the final 2 minutes, presented to you by FedEx, we live to deliver.
And you know, San Juan has bagged two titles in this year alone. Should they go on to win this one? One is the crossover cup, and this one is the more the sweeter,
the coveted Northern Conference title. And there are smiles all around on the San Juan side. Well, as expected, the long faces on the side of Manila. Manila will use a 30.
And one of the other players that we chose is Chito Vicolero. We like his style of maneuvering, 12 points, 4 rebounds. Look at the number of assists. I believe that's 12.
12, oh, yes. So. Times 2, 24.
Times 2, 24. At saka
36 points.
Ang galing ng pagka-backstop niya. No? And when the points were needed, he drilled in those 15-footers. We highlighted that at the half.
Just a minute and 25 remaining. Newton. Peter Martin. So it's interesting how the offseason will be for the Manila Metro Stars and perhaps for the all the other teams as the NBA enters a new page in its history. Newton knocks in the shot. He has 4 points. And Newton is one happy dude. Parang Tagalog na naman ito mamaya.
Sigurado yan.
Only 46 seconds before San Juan is officially crowned as the new Northern Conference champion. Manila jammed at least the threat of being swept away in 3 games. Took one here yesterday. But today, it is all San Juan. Only 15 seconds before it is official. Kalani Pereira. Newton will go to the line. Prolonging the inevitable. And the untired troop of players is the Manila Metro Stars. Talagang pagod at this point.
And they know it, Seth. Yeah. You know, one thing good about the Manila Metro Stars, you know that they are the defending champions. You know that they play clean on the floor.
They defended their title well, ano ha?
Some celebration going on the side of the San Juan Knights.
It's just gonna, umpisa na eh.
You call it a pocket celebration because they're not at home, but expect some partying going on tonight in San Juan.
Yes. This was the record, it should be said, that Mayor Jingoy Estrada is there. And I think his presence has also helped the team. Pag nandiyan yung team manager mo, kahit sino pa siya, di ba? If you become my team manager, I'll play my heart out. And it's official. We have a new Northern Conference champion, the San Juan Knights. And the San Juan Knights will go on to meet the Negro Slashers. What a game, what a series that will be. And we have a few more things that we'd like to complete here. We'll have JC Gonzalez chat with Coach Philip Cesar in just a short while. We'll have the awarding of the trophy
to your Manila Metro Stars.
Metro Stars end their season.
And
the champions have been dethroned.
And a bigger hand for the Northern Conference champions, the San Juan Knights.
And the Knights meet the Slashers. Emotional series yan, nakikita
ko. Oo, kita-kita natin na it's gonna be one tough series, especially dun sa Bacolod, no? It's gonna be a 2-3-2 affair.
Yes, Philip Cesar is now with JC Gonzalez.
I'm with a very happy man, the Northern Conference coach, champion, Coach Philip Cesar. Ano masasabi mo sa performance ng boys mo yun? Everybody played so well.
Well, talagang they really give, you know, the best of this game. They play top, they play very, very hard on defense. Siguro yun talaga ang nagbigay. Nakita nila yung game kahapon, masyado silang relax, even defensively. Kaya, you know, hindi namin nakuha kahapon. But now, nakita ko bawat isa yung sa umpisa, sa start pa lang ng game, talagang binibigay na nila. So, well, I'm happy for them and I'm happy that we get this Northern Conference champion.
Coach, we're playing on the road, pero nakita nyo man, ang daming San Juan fans dito na sa stands. Ano masasabi mo sa kanila?
Well, unang-una, nagpapasalamat ako sa mga sumusuporta sa San Juan Knights. Lalong-lalo na yung mga tao na dito. So, halos sa kalahati nitong gym, sa amin din, ano, mga taga-Andok. Binabati ko kayo lahat. And of course, dun sa, andyan sa bahay namin.
Alright, Coach Philip Cesar, congratulations once again.
Okay, thank you. Salamat.
Okay, Steph, Danny, back to you.
Thanks a lot, and we have the trophy already being awarded. There's the mayor, of course. Just Commissioner Oji Narvazo made the presentation earlier. And you can understand the celebration all around. Masaya itong group on top.
Oo, at una-una, kailangan mo nila mag-celebrate. Kita mo si Philip Newton. You know, Seth, after this championship, is yet another goal that maybe San Juan or the Negro Slashers may want to achieve, and that is the national championships. But a very good series run by this... all new cast tayo
yes,
for the national
exactly,
series.
Exactly. On behalf of all of us here, we have Danny, Rhea, as well as JC. It's been a pleasure presenting the northern side of things here in the NBA. Final score, 112-83. The San Juan Knights take the Northern Conference title. It's going to be Negros against San Juan for the national title of NBA 2000. Lead pass, Brown has to put it up because he was running out of space. Compton picks it up, fires a three, and we are already tied.
And that's a good sign for the Metro Stars and for Alex Compton. 2 out of 18, first two games, Compton making his three-pointer. First three-pointer in this game.
And that Islander three is a blessing.